How can we value the urban forest so in Korea? So actually the day before yesterday I presented the on the particular matters dust networks in our countries, but today I'd like to mention some valuation and what I'd like to suggest some what is a standard statistics in ASEAN regions. I think we need to make some standard statistics. Actually, I'm a government researcher, so actually last month we received a question from the parliament, parliament's politician, why WHO, actually World Health Organization, WHO designated as the 15 square meter, 9 square meter is a minimum standard, yes. And 15 square meter is some proper standard. So what is the source of the that figure? So it is a very question. So actually, I'd like to share, I'd like to know the are there anyone who know the what is the data source under the 9 square meter and 15 square meter? Yes. So and next I will start my presentation with a question on the WHO standard. And yes, so maybe you can see this many times. So actually now 70 years ago, our Korean peninsula was destroyed and denuded like this, but the Korean government had embarked on the, some national project like this. So it's many celebrity, they mentioned the successful rehabilitation in Korea. So also we in Seoul area, 70 years ago, in 1955, the landscape was denuded 93, like this. But in nowadays, it's there's a green and gray. I think I called it the harmony between green and gray. And so it's, I think it's not so good place to live the to habit for birds. Yeah. Also, but I live in Seoul. Yeah. Yes, I'll skip. And yeah, actually, I'd like to mention the definition of the urban forest. So in Korea, in Seoul, we define the, what is the urban forest. So we call it forest and trees. And we in outer part areas, as you say, some so fairly urban areas. Fairly urban area is dominated by big mountain areas like this. So we call it in rural area, but it's some fairly urban areas dominated by this forest area. But in the center of the urban is highly dominated by residential and some central business district. So it is very difficult to compare the green space among ASEAN countries. So I think that we come to know, or we should some designate the what is the definition of the urban forest in ASEAN regions. So actually, 2019 in Korea, all over the world, all our country, all over the countries, the green area per capita value is 11.51 square meter. So minimum requirement more than 9 square meter, but under the 15.0 square meters. So, but I do not know what is the data source and the minimum requirement and the proper recommendation. Yes, still I do not know. Yeah, so also when we compare the each cities, from China, Japan, and OECD cities. I think it's the cultural status and some political status very different. Yeah, so it is very unreasonable to compare the which country is more green, of course it's lower green. I think it's not, so, but some scientific analysis of the green space is very important to know the value and to know the to increase the enhance the value of the urban forest. So in poor wealthier cities. So I mentioned that Wang and Liu 2017 I cited. This result, and in Japan case, I cited the OECD result. Also, it is very difficult, but this Asia Pacific Urban Forest Meeting, I think we can make some scientific small meeting to make some standard or the definition and some statistics. So in Korea, actually, we divided some very urban forests as landscape forest, very urban forest, and the park forest. Also, street trees is very important. Also, pocket grow, very small, one meter by 1 meter, only just the, square meters, very small, but it's a very important place. Yeah. So, small pocket growers and school green also important, but we have no in calculating the total statistics in our country. This small groves and small school is not included. So if we conducted some satellite image analysis, it is very easy. Yeah, but some area is very restricted to understand and to calculate the green areas in these areas. Yeah, like this. Yes. So as I mentioned maybe 2 days ago, that in Korea in Seoul and in metropolitan city, we want to design designate the ecosystem service urban forest like this. So regulation part is very the diverse criteria, and some provision is very small. But in ASEAN regions, actually Malaysia and Indonesia and that areas, this provision service will be important. So it is depending on the cultural status of the cities. So actually, this in Korea, actually, previous maybe 10 years ago, some top-down disciplines like this green road, green leaf, or vertical green shelter, green loop is some government policy, but now it's some market policy, market-driven trends is popular. So tree delivery service, the urban rhythm or urban bees and companion trees. This part is some bottom-up process, and this is a top-down process. So now I think it's some paradigm change time in Korea. The change of the paradigm is now occurred in some metropolitan cities. Yes, I will skip. And actually, I'd like to mention this. So in Korean Peninsula, we calculated some access to the green space. So usually we compare the area of the green space, but I think it's a time to compare the access to the green space. So if we hypersize the 4 kilometers per hour, 4 kilometers speed, walking speed, so 15 minutes, what is the nearest distance from the until the in the 15 minutes is very important to calculate, to assess the access to the green space in Korea. So we just tried to this. Yes. Actually, that is all. And I'd like to present some sounds of birds. Yeah. Yes, this bird also you can, yeah. So English name is a winter wren. Yeah, I call it is a serenade in urban forest. It's a very beautiful song, wonderful song. So if we well care and preserve the urban forest, we can hear this song.